Okay, so let me start off this talk with explaining that Kobayashi Noritada is unfortunately not here today because he had other consequences. So unfortunately he's not here, but he has sent me some questions and he's currently online on IRC watching us in Japan. He has a lot of questions for the other teams because we have many problems in Japanese translation teams, and he would like to know much about the best practices that the French teams have gone through and other teams have gone through, and maybe other teams can learn from it. Okay. The main situation with currently in Japanese translation team is that we are doing translation with only in a mailing list. We have mailing lists where people dump translations and submit to the BTS and other things. And they are sometimes reviewed, sometimes not, and they are reviewed on the mailing list and they are sent down to the mailing list. What's the problem is that the review is sometimes thorough, sometimes not. And it's not really easy to tell whether it was a thorough review or not. How much review you go through, you have to go through the mailing list to check. So, well, there's information, but it's not really tracked. So we're kind of feeling that Japanese translation is not getting enough reviews, and it's not pretty easy to track how much review is done. So, how do you do that?
I think Pluto have a model to manage revisions.
Pluto is supposed to have a model for this. I'm not completely sure that it's
works.
Already implemented.
Oh,
it's on the roadmap.
Now you can make suggestions.
Yeah.
And can review, one person or some person can
use it. There is a concept of suggestions. And a concept of commit.
Yes.
So this is something we don't have in the process of with the mailing list, where someone translates, good or bad, no one knows, and other people make reviews, probably in public. That's one of the main points, I think, doing review in public. Because if someone, okay, I spoke slowly enough. If someone makes a stupid suggestion, it has to be seen by others. So not only the review should review the translation, but the review should review the reviews. Okay, do you get it? Yeah, it's very important that some people, and this is more or less what I'm doing in the French team, just spot review and see, hey, no, don't suggest this. This is not a good idea. This is not the way we usually translate this. Okay? But tracking the review, how many reviews are needed, I can't tell. Basically, I think that more or less conscientiously, that English, this strange word,
consensus,
conscientious, without knowing what you do. Yeah. When the translator is someone well known, the review is less thorough. And when, yeah, of the door. When the translator is a well-known one, someone we know more or less that he or she is doing good job, well, when it comes to me, actually, I just overread the things and I say, okay, sounds fair, and just to check the spelling and whatever. Depends on the... So there, I think there is a kind of informal rating of people, but nothing written. Just the newbies, we will be a little bit more careful because they will make the mistakes we all made. So that, but nothing really, I know that speaking in name of French team, we have the reputation of very complicated and very detailed processes. This is not complicated.
So you don't have a very complex process in the French team?
We do have a complex process. When something is to be translated, we post a message to the list with a kind of standard subject translation, TAF, T-A-F, translation to do means in French. So, and then someone says, okay, I want to translate this, so intent to translate. This is a well-known process and other teams use it. And then someone picks up the translation, intent to translate, and then does the translation and posts a request for review. And then people review. And here it stops being formalized. There can be 10 reviews. There can be one or no review at all. And at some moment, the translator by himself has to decide, okay. Then last chance for comments, and then I send translation.
So you send the translation?
The translator, always the translator. Okay. Not some kind of dictator of the team who does everything. The translator, this is the translator's duty. But no one in the teams says to him, okay, go. It's up to him to decide. I don't know about the Brazilian Portuguese team.
Brazilian Portuguese was in the same for 2 years now, based on the French team.
Yeah, I think
Dutch team is using, Spanish team is using. Although it's not the same robot, but it's the same.
Yeah.
It's the same workflow. I think.
Romanian also now.
Catalan team also.
Catalan team.
I think Catalan team also. There are some teams that's impossible, right? We have like one translator doing everything. And usually they don't do it. So.
Yeah. The small team, they just can't do anything but just translate. But I have no solution to this. Being a volunteer, team of volunteers, it's very hard to say. We have no, and I don't know of any team having an assignment process. Mm-hmm. Say, okay, there's something to do. I'm the boss and I give it to you. It's completely volunteer. If I post a translation to do somewhere, well, it has to wait until someone picks it up.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's interesting. Do you have any comments?
Have sense to make the same workflow for every team? Separately, the big team that the small teams. The small team, which well, it's one person, have no sense to make a workflow. But use the same workflow. Use in Poodle.
The workflow, do you mean inside Poodle or any
time? I mean proceed. A way to work in similarly.
In fact, the workflow is open. It is curious because you don't have it written anywhere. So usually teams that are looking for some organization starts looking for other teams. That's the way that happened in Brazilian Portuguese. Mm-hmm. And I found these strange tags in the French team that they have this staff, RFR, and that. And I started asking people. And somebody said, look, read this document. And there is an HTML that explains the workflow, but it's not well known. And it's up to Inc. You just need to start using, and we can activate the robots that scans that on the main list. So the workflow is based on a page that is generated hourly. With who owns a translation or a review or a bug or something?
This is outside of Putin.
This is outside of Putin.
I think we should.
Testing for now.
Sorry?
No, we use this. Maybe we will change it in future.
I think it should be useful to integrate all the tools because in this way are more. Two separated between each other and should be integrated, and if the tool is not used, just remove it because it's so much confusing when you try to make it work. That's my experience at least.
Is
Putu
currently used anywhere?
Yeah, Putu is used, isn't it?
No.
No, it's not used. No,
nobody uses it.
No one uses Putu.
So
no,
we are still at Stone Age, mailing each other.
Yeah.
Throwing mail at each other, not yet using any tools. Well, maybe this is a tool.
Maybe it would be convenient if someone has a laptop to just show we have tools. Like these robots and the like.
Maybe
so we do have tools.
We can pull them. We can use our computer again for that.
But Grizu wants to hack. So
okay. I can do it.
And he has a damn German keyboard.
Just this one. You
I like to use one.
Mine doesn't switch. Yeah, I don't know why.
I'm not sure this.
About Junichi's question and. We do have a tutor, but it's not using tutor currently.
I used it yesterday. It's got an American keyboard.
Not exactly my favorite one, but it's worse than German one.
Okay, thanks.
Shit.
You see. If you can use the browser,
I need to get the URL. I want to show the robot.
Oh, at the wall, it is smoking eyes.
Well, I have a quick question.
Yeah.
Which language teams members are here? I know French.
Yeah.
Brazilian.
Brazilian, Portuguese.
I'm not really Spanish translation.
Yeah,
so.
We are a little bit short of official language. I can speak for the. Well, I know about the processes of the Spanish team, more or less, because we talked a lot with Javier Fernandez. I'm not sure about The German team.
It has to reboot.
The German team uses.
The
German team seems to use the robot to.
The robot now. I think that a few people popped up recently, and they now they use the robot. So the Catalan team more or less uses the robot also.
Okay. Japanese team uses a web page maintained by Kenshi Muto, and there's a manual process.
Where is the internet?
You can probably use this one. Yeah, you were explaining the Japanese team.
Okay. Japanese team uses a manual process for that, especially for Debian Weekly News. That was an exceptional process for Debian Weekly News, but that was the one which was most active when it was active. And they had assignments of the searches to people. And they assigned these parts to people, and they were meant to translate it by the deadline. And that seemed to go around very well, but Debian Weekly News is no longer weekly, so people are looking for something new to translate.
Yeah. And what other parts are the Japanese team working on? Pure DevCon? Or is this done on a team-based process or not?
Well, Pure DevCon is done by Kenshi Muto and Yamane-san. So there's only two people working on it. And Kenshi Muto does a web page of tracking who's doing what. Mm-hmm. And Kenshi Muto does the difficult part, and Yamane-san does the easier part. So there's a very simple role and responsibility. Yeah.
Anything that is a file can go under rocks because of the way that it was designed. So WMLs, PO files, PO.coms, what else we have?
Man pages,
documentation, anything can go because we use URLs. This is the PC URLs. And we can do that. We learned that, at least the Brazilian Portuguese team, while we are translating the policy is too deep. So a team of people was translating the policy. So to register the different chapters, you can use different URLs. So it's quite easy to use the robots to track things out manually.
To show if you have a browser.
The screen really needs this end of the screen needs to have
it's
not
a big problem.
It's okay. Okay, we can
see it's just to see the idea.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can I borrow your laptop just to make sure? I think it would be more.
Okay, now do you need the Beirut or do you want it
to? No, I don't need the Beirut. I just need a browser to work in network.
Alright.
And so that you can show, maybe it's easier to show the process with the browser, mailing list, and whatever. So I hope he's listening on the other side of the planet. itn.nhow. itn.debian. I want to show the robots first. Slash Debian dash ltn. Okay, everybody spotted the URL. Okay, so there is no home page or whatever. Here we see the output of the robot for all teams.
Nine teams
will use it. So I apologize in advance, I take the French part because I more or less know of what's happening in there. So here we see all activities, either it's sorted by bug report, by date, package, etc. etc. I'll take it by package. So here we see first the type. It's not always easy to follow because I'm not the one using this page most. So we have a kind of coordinator who tracks this down and wakes up people when something is waiting for too long.
By status is the best way.
By status is the best.
Oh, okay.
By status is the workflow. Okay. Here we are. We have the first step of the translation work. The TAF. TAF means in French traduction, affaire, translation to do. It's a playing on words actually. TAF also means is slang for work. So this DAV FS2, this is a PO, why PO? I want to show you. Yeah. That's a PO. This DAV FS2 program, there's a type PO means this is an upstream so-called translation. So this is not a PO that comes, not a man page, just a program. Okay? The file is always named. Nearly always afr.io. The TAF has been sent on 5th of March, and there is a link to the lists archive, which I open in the new tab. And it just says it points to the list archive, and Thomas just sent this mail, and you see the subject. It's kind of standardized. Says that, okay, this is what you have to do. PO, this is the type, the package, name of the file, and 137U, so 137 strings to translate. So if I want to pick this up, I know I have a lot of work. So this is basically probably why no one did pick this up.
Why you are talking to me?
Hmm?
Why you are talking to me?
I have to talk to someone. Okay, so this was the first step, see? And then we have a few others. So the coordinator, as you see, that needs a kind of coordinator, someone who watches this frequently. And he can say, okay, I posted this on 5th of March and no one picked up. I should maybe ring a bell and we start again. And this was tough. MAG, here also this is one of the acronyms, which is French, mise à jour, update, means update. This is the same thing for the package named Brunet. There's a PO.conf translation, and posted on 11th of June, and if I look at it, I see. Yeah, I did post it on Monday, 11th of June, and probably no one picked up on this update to do. So we should work it up, because there were 9 fuzzy and 3 untranslated, so small work. It should be done. But I'm in depth, so I cannot do that. Yeah. Next step is ITT, intent to translate. So let's take an example. On 12th of June, CBU for unknown proxy, just say okay. I'm okay. I will do this translation. It was like 10 days ago. He did nothing, so I should beat him and get the translation. The text is not really relevant anyway. The most important is.
And the ITT is a way to avoid duplication of work.
Yeah.
You know that somebody's...
Thanks, yeah. I forgot to mention this. This is pretty much important. So ITT, there should be few things in ITT because it's just a temporary state. And if you look, there are many various different types of translation. That could be a PO4A, so that means some translation, probably this is kernel handbook, this is a big document, I think.
Right.
Manuals, there are a lot of translation of DDP type, because this is not PO. In that case, this is probably XML translation. So he posted PO. Nobody speaks French around. Okay, this is awful spelling. I don't want this translator. He said, I will do this part. I remember I saw him and I say, oh, not him. Okay. There are a few such status.
There are WMLs, which is should be something like definitely news.
Yeah. PO, as I said. And the biggest part is probably the I never know how to pronounce this in English. RFR, request for review. Here the acronym is English. All teams use it, just like ITT. And we see a lot of such requests for review. For instance, this one I should close it, but yeah, Evolutive. And here, again, we point to my message, my last message with a complete attachment. So everything goes to the list. That's the main point.
So does the robot scan the mailing list?
Yep. Okay. The robot scans the mailing list and generates these pages. So the robot is maintained in the Debian-LTNM CDS. And it runs on the host itnm.debian.net, which is named Churro. For the German people who can't pronounce Churro, it's named also Spitz. That's just a joke. Okay, this is the host that has been donated by the region of Extremadura in Spain. So this machine already runs the robot. And actually the robot has only to be taught that this team for this language uses that mailing list.
It's only enabled, it's on a flag. You just say scans this list and use this language code and it works. And Orly, like last time it was 17, it is, if I'm not wrong, it is GMT, or GMT plus 2, something like that. And it's Orly, scanned, and it closes the bugs in these pages once a day. That's another advantage, but
yeah,
Christian is going to talk about
in
a minute.
I will go over there. So if I go down, I saw the request for review. There's a lot of them, of course, because this is work in progress. I don't remember. I think they are sorted in some way by date.
They are sorted by date.
So actually, the coordinator. No, they are not.
No, by the RFRs are by letter. It's alphabetic.
By letter, yeah. That should be by date, because it could be easier for this coordinator to spot.
There is an option by date. There is another page that is by date.
Okay, by date. And then the coordinator can just look at all things that everybody forget about and just ring a bell again. So that needs, again, you see, a coordinator, someone who cares, one or two or three or whatever. LC, next status is LCFC, last change for comments, and this is the moment where okay, this is we reviewed, everybody agrees there has been some changes or not, or maybe not. As I told, this we cannot control. Sometimes you have a huge threat in the mailing list, sometimes there is nothing, and at some moment, without explicit definition, some moment we decide to go the next step and say, okay, nobody reacted, so it's probably correct, and then that's
for Brazilian Portuguese. We have the double rule. If you have date
timelines like projects meet,
yeah.
meet, then if you have no review onto the timeline, you send your translation. But if there is no timeline, you have to wait until somebody review at least once the file.
The system is simple enough to allow teams to adapt themselves. But there is nothing it did to track the fact that you had or had no review. That's probably a weakness somewhere. And then after the LCFC, the translator will send a bug report, the package, for things that are related to a package. Example, let's take add user, translation of add user. Nicola sent first, he sent a bug report with the file attached, etc. So we have a link for this bug report.
So you scan the BTS as well?
No, I will go for it. Okay. If he sends this bug report, he gets the bug number back. And then he has to send a message to the mailing list again to say, hey, BTS for this translation, and there's a new field, it's a field, which gives the bug number.
You can use various two options. You can use these or you can use together with BTS.
Oh, yeah. We always use that one, so this is more strict for reasons. It's more logical to say BTS colon or whatever.
It's BTS sharp
and the bug number. That's probably more logical for teams who begin their work. It's more logical. And then, so there are several manual operations, and well, the bug reports. If I come back to the bug reports. There is some non-written rule that says the subject should be kind of formalized or kind of standard. But actually, it's not used by anything. You see the subject here, it's IN10FTL:FR. French translation update. It's not really used. It could be. It could be, for instance, if I send a bug report and then the robot crawls the BTS, but well, that would be quite heavy.
Yeah.
So, but we could imagine something. Because here we have two manual operations. The translator has to send a bug report. He has to remember that when he gets back the number, he has to mail to the mailing list. Otherwise, there's a problem. But we will see it because the coordinator will see, okay, this package is in LCFC for 1 week. This is not normal. Actually, here there are a few that are not normal. And that's pretty much all. And yeah, when Felipe said, when the robot once a day scans the BTS and goes to each of these bugs here and just checks whether they are closed or not. And when they are closed, the line is removed and thing disappears, the process is complete. So this helps to track down the bad maintainers who do not fix their bugs, at least for localization, by date, for instance. It can help in any new campaign, for instance. There are a few special tags like fix,
I don't remember. NMUs.
NMUs, yeah.
NMUs.
So the same, but the bug is fixed but not closed. One fix is, I think, obvious.
GDN should disappear because it's no longer a template file.
DON is also special. I usually use it when I have commit access
in some parts or some package development, and when I directly commit, I don't send a bug report. So it's not tracked in the BTS actually, it's considered DON. And hold is hold.
Most of the time this is to say, okay, we know that there is some work to do for this package, for instance, altitude, but for whatever reason, it's not the moment to do it. Because the maintainer said, okay, yeah, I broke some stuff, but I will break another stuff, so. So that's most what usually when you read mainly about the robot, French robot and Dutch robot and the like.
You can show the information about the tags. This is not directly on the pseudo
robots. Yeah. Okay, yeah. This is probably the page to use for teams who want to start their own process. If I take the Japanese team as example, that could be interesting. If I think that it needs some manpower somewhere, because you need a coordinator, you need enough translators. If there are only two people working, I'm not sure it's really useful. I don't know because Junichi mentioned Kenshi maintaining a web page, so he could maintain the web page by using the robot actually.
So now because Kenshi's web page is like a wiki.
Is that a wiki?
People need to manually edit, and it's not really.
One of the things that like we've been thinking about small teams is that if you are only one translator, like Titi, reporting bugs all around, you can use the robot just to track your own bugs on this page. So you can just send a mail to the list and say, BTS, bug number, package, full, and it will appear there. And it will be closed automatically, so you know when to bug somebody. And during NMU campaigns, it can help also the people, the person doing the NMU. So. The bots are extensible, and like you said that you assign different paragraphs, you can change the URL. Because for the robot, the URL is the most important thing. So once you change the URL to say like WML, Debian Weekly News, Wiki 50 P1 for paragraph 1, that's an absolute name. You can divide it by 12 paragraphs and you can have multiple review process running simultaneously. That's the advantage of the robot.
What's the URL you're talking about?
The URL of the robot?
It's the subject line.
Yeah, okay.
It's in the format of a URL.
Yeah.
It is type colon dash colon slash slash name of the package slash file or subdirectory or whatever it is.
So I assume that there's already Arabic and Turkish that is not if it's Latin one, can Japanese teams join in this system, or is it difficult? I mean, who can ask?
I think the URLs are.
Yeah, I think that the Japanese team could. They're not. That wouldn't be an obstacle. You know, the Arabic team is using. It's a very small team. Arabic team actually is made of two persons. So the system is not very widely used, but it is more or less used. So I don't know if we look at by date.
Yeah. Mohammed sent a lot of stuff.
But they are old.
Very old.
You can also use this kind of, you see the URL using like regular expression,
yeah,
the name of the package, comma, package, comma, package, comma.
A lot of translation,
I can check with Thomas,
but
I'm pretty sure that there is no problem. And if there is, it should be easy topics.
Most of the robot is maintained by Thomas Urio. Should I write it down? Or anybody? H-U-R-I-A-U-X. So
I think
I didn't understand the alphabet.
I will repeat. I just typed it down.
I think on the page, on the pseudo URL page has his name. Or even anyone of the openings in the bottom line.
Yeah.
Contact him. No, that's not. But in the generated pages, I think.
Generated pages, I think. Here.
Control plus plus. To break, to make the letter bigger, or you can read it.
Can you read it?
I think he has. I think he has the page on the song.
So.
I can enlarge.
But it might be useful for the people who are viewing the stream.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
I have some.
You have zoomed?
Yep.
Okay, thanks. Anyway, you have the contact of person doing the work, but anything about this can and should, I think, be discussed in the DBM-I89 mailing list, more than private stuff.
Okay. You can show maybe the French archive of the list so people can see it.
Yes.
You can also use the German mailing list key.
Yeah. You want to see the German one? Okay. Let's see what happened in June.
Yeah. Then you can see the various bugs being closed or bugs being registered.
See if we see some. This is an interesting thread. Not because the first mail is mine, but here I did send an automated mail during a review campaign, and the German team received peace updates, DevConf PO translation for Squid, and then Helge, who acts more or less as the coordinator. Yeah, transform this mail into a request for review. That means he picked up the translation, because it's probably his translation, and then he immediately sent a request for review as a follow-up. What's interesting is to use threads, because it helps a lot.
Yes.
Here we see, we are in QA process here, because he sent the DE.PO file, and then Thomas Weber sent, okay, D4Lager is ambition, blah, blah, blah. So I don't know what he wants to say, but he sends a diff. The main point being, it has to be easy to both read and apply. And the German team uses compressed diffs. The French one does not. It's up to. I think it's.
It was discussed at one time. It's probably some years ago already on the GNOME DE mailing list.
Yeah.
That there seems to be a bug within some evolution client version that wasn't able to properly view
text attachments which have a different encoding than the mail itself, and it completely fucked up something, so they started using zipped file attachments.
Yeah, this is a common trick to send zipped file B to files to avoid encoding problems. This was also very often used by the Japanese translators. Because of messing up with encodings and people opening your nicely encoded files and breaking them down. Well, this is something I personally don't like very much, because I think that now we are over these problems. So it makes just a little bit more work when you receive such files, because you have to Zcat it or unzip it or whatever, that make just a one more step, and when you have 10 of these, it's kind of boring. So, but the main point is, yeah, this person sends a leaf, and then what happens after? Helge apparently answered again. Okay, this is an obvious fault, okay, and he probably sends a corrected file.
No.
They are currently here in the process to discuss. Okay, there is something, he made a remark, he agrees or what, I don't know. And, well, they skipped the last chance for comments step, and actually he jumped to the BTS step. This is probably the process of journey.
Yeah, when I learned to use this process, it is an agreement that when there is a correction in somewhere, you use LCFC. When the review, everybody says that's okay, go ahead like 3 or 4 times, there is no need for last chance for time. But again, it's working on Brazilian Portuguese, other teams probably use it.
Yeah, we mostly use these days. UDEV to be translated, then I send the formal mail saying, okay, this has to be translated, NAG, because this is an update, not a new translation. Then Jean-Luc sends intent to translate. Then a few days later, I request for you a few follow-ups, more or less formalized. Let's take this one. Okay, it says there's a typo somewhere in the diff. So even he didn't send any diff because it was completely obvious. And finally, after some moments, Jean-Luc sent a last chance for comments mail with encoding problems, whatever.
The list archives, yes.
Yeah, list archives. And maybe there has been some comments after all. And no, that's interesting. If you look at dates, on LCFC, it was May 2, May 2nd. Last change for comments. Then nothing happened. And our beloved coordinator, Thomas, on May 26th, so 3 weeks after, just look at the robot page and say, oh, what's happening? And he just says, okay, BTS, please. And then we have sending one day after, okay, I forgot, and the BTS. So then, mainly the process can be tracked down.
So the assumption is that if anybody has reviewed the translation, he has reviewed with the full vigor and energy and emotion, that he has thoroughly reviewed it.
which is not true. But anyway, in these days we have a lot, if you see, this is only May, and we have a lot of threads. Each one of these threads in the review. And if I look very carefully, I certainly find threads where you have DAF, ITT, RFR, LCFC, BTS, and nothing happens. No one just even answered. This is probably not the best, but the best we can do.
Some teams prefer to have the robot receiving the emails. That is slightly different, and I think there is only Dutch team doing that.
So there's a mailing list for Dutch?
They have a mailing list, but they use Dutch.dev.net, right? Can you check this?
Yeah, maybe.
I think it's Dutch stuff that we're working on.
Yeah.
This is basically the same team, but they use a MySQL database, and the robot has an email address. So translators does not send emails to the list. They send them to the robot, and the robot keeps tracking of that.
When you say they, should be he, because most of the time this is a...
Yeah. I can see four names, but basically Kobako is in everything.
I'm not sure about their color codes conventions. Probably seems to be related to the status.
It's the status. It's pretty much like ours.
Yeah.
RFR is yellow, BTS blue. And
if one looks at their mailing list,
they have only the discussions.
Yeah, only the discussion. You have the RFR, LCFC, and then it stops. Yeah, see. Well. But that probably depends on various.
Yes, the team doesn't. Yeah, we once discussed it with Thomas, and he said that, well, we can have that also on our robot. There is no problem. And actually, eventually, we will merge everything to one single point because it's easier for everyone.
What to say more about QA? I don't know if he has other topics to.
So what, where does Puto come into this picture?
Nowhere.
Okay.
Nowhere.
Okay. Puto
is currently outside and is considered to be experimental stuff. itnens.debian.net :8080 The main point currently is saying, yeah, this is an experimental server, don't base that. If I take something like Boho, don't take 5 minutes. Let's see. What we need to see at the moment is how to interface a Puttol and the material. So the main point currently is try to automate the import of the material into Puttol, and then we will take care of what to do with the material.
So I have a question about this. So we have the mailing list, mail, so we send files by attachment, and we use the Zcat tools to view them. Is there any tool to facilitate the reviews and checking, or do you use the manpower to overcome it?
Yeah. Anyone feel to answer?
Who does review over there? You do.
At times, yeah.
How do you do it?
Depends completely on what kind of translation I do review. I often review also upstream things. I'm working on the VESNOT, on the game translation team, and to review the PO files directly there. I put my marker into the file up until where I did review it at the time, because I don't have the time to go through one file completely because they are huge. Well, it really, I have found my own workflow for doing it, and I'm sending batches of updates, not the complete file, but after some stages I did the review, I send it on. But something that would work better and more like a real workflow, something like that would probably enhance it and maybe enable others to refuse too. This is one of the main things I want to get enabled. I like the way that the DTTS is doing it with the review system. And more or less this is the only thing where I really see that review is part of the workflow and is really done. I don't see reviews done in very much other areas. To some degree my complete system is switched to German, so you can take that as sort of review too, because I'm usually sending in problems when I notice them in my system.
So review is that using the system you will notice. So that's one review. I mean, you can review the raw, PO, etc. data, but that's sometimes big, so you have to sort of look. But is there any tools to facilitate looking at the files except for using Emacs or Vi or whatever?
Yes.
Okay.
There are a couple of different approaches. For DI, we have cool stuff that runs under SEPI. Poodle also does that, which is checking for parentheses, checking for variable names, checking for spell check for a language that wants to enable that. That it happens on DI. There are scripts just checking, and you can go to a page and see, oh, Brazilian Portuguese has four variables with broken names, because probably we don't spot it, there is a change that we didn't see, or it's just a typo, so you can hunt it and fix. And there is also spell checking, words that they can't find, and this is me. Poodle does that when you import. He does checks like number of parentheses in the message ID, like you have four parentheses, so the translation doesn't have four parentheses, it's broken. And there's a lot of other kind of checks in this way. For VI, and this is basically what I use, and I know that Nicola also is using VI. I use a spell checker inside VI, which makes the work easier. I don't need to look for spell checking, which means big focus on translation. And now we have the compendiums, which in some graphical tools it works out of the box. In the case of VI, we need to merge before starting translating. So you get the compendium, you get the new PO, you merge it, and then you start translating. So what he finds in the companion gets translated at this point.
How do you get the companion to work?
To work on the tools? I really don't know, because I don't use graphical tools, but usually they, like, KBabel has a field for companions.
You get the file and you say to K-Mobile, here is the companion. But it seems that Eddie is the only one that is able to do the companion's work on K-Mobile.
Yes. I can't.
And that's the mainly PA tools that I know. VI has some nice tools for the translations, but we are not using that overall archive. Not yet.
On my side, I basically for review, actually, I just opened the file and read it and change it. And where all this is being wrapped into a script, that first copy the file as an original file, then I open in an Emacs, and then modify what I consider to be changed, and then the script creates a diff file. The point is sending the diff file, so that you can see the original and the modified.
In Brazilian Portuguese, we use a rule. It's an informal rule. Every time that a review happens, you should send the new PO file, the diff from the read, and the reasons for your change. Not only because we have translators like just sending the new translation, and you said, okay, what have you translated? What have you changed? That there is a need to regenerate the diffs, and with the diff. And the new PO, if the translator accepts everything, it's easier to just say, okay, I accept everything, less chances for comments, less. And also explaining, like, I fix a typo, or I fix, that's not the best way to translate that, or historically we have been using that. In Brazil, we use a standard vocabulary from the Brazilian Linux documentation project. Mainly because you want to keep the consistency with the rest of Linux translations. Most of them are using this. But I don't know if it's using other languages.
Actually, we're pretty bad at this. As far as I know, our only thesaurus is our memories. Which is not very good.
And we are talking about very different size teams. That's another. We have teams in Debian that's really only one person, and we are not kidding. And they are doing much more job than some of teams that have 5-6 people. And we have the French teams that there are the golden teams with like 20 people working.
Well, I have no idea. It depends on the moment. More or less.
Yeah, but usually
like 20, yes.
Yeah. The largest teams have like 20, 25 people working on sometimes.
So I have a question about PO files. If you send PO files through message merge, you would change a bit, so you have problems with diffs. So are you careful not to send this PO files through message merge? Or how do you work around it?
Message merge has some options to not mix with the IDs.
Yeah. That this is mostly related to the various versions of GetText. GetText change a lot its default behavior from version to version. So yeah, sometimes when you're not careful enough, you can just reformat completely file. What we recommend, especially with the method I mentioned where I just copy the file and then diff, I usually recommend to not change the wrapping and not send the file to message cat, for instance, which we reformat. That's important. I think that during the review, the layout of the file should not be changed to make it easier to spot the real changes.
We try to keep it wrapped to 8 lines, mostly because it's consolidated.
Yeah.
I learned that
should be done. Yeah. My opinion, that should be done at the end. When I send a bug report, I do it with a script. I just go to the directory and I send bug-update foo. Foo is the package. And there is first a message cat. The file at the very, very last step. But in the review process, it's better to not change the layout. And for the review process to happen, the PO files must be wrapped, not use very long line.
Like Kbabel.
Oh, right.
Okay. Yeah. Kbabel, when you save a file with Kbabel, it saves it with only one line.
It makes diff harder also.
Yeah. And I often forget about reformatting. I know for that.
Do you use Kbabel? Do you use Kbabel?
Yeah, I do. I do.
Is that useful?
Me too. I use Kbabel.
Is that useful to use Kbabel?
Yes.
In my opinion, yes, because I use it. So.
What do you think of the project? I can't remember the name. It starts with an N, four letters, and it puts everything out as an object. So you don't have the whole file. You only have the part that needs to
be. Xleaf.
This is Xleaf format.
What?
Xleaf.
Xlife. Xleaf. XLIFF.
That's not the one I was thinking about. But anyway, when you talk about the file, are you taking the whole file with the all of the C++ or Python or whatever code and translating that, or are you just translating
no.
the you're no. only translating the part that's that the user sees, but is that in a separate place, or is it?
This is this is the PO file.
The PO file puts
yeah,
it in
this
a separate
is,
place.
This is all what's around the GetText software, which extracts
uh-huh.
translatable strings, which are marked for translation, and then puts them in a dedicated file where you have the original strings, and then translations.
Mm-hmm.
And with this format you can use special tools like Kbabel, but also just text editors.
VI for instance has a PO mode. You have a PO mode that you can use some special combination to copy
yes.
strings, go for the next translator, find the next fuzzy.
So
there
is a PO mode in Emacs. I think Kbabel has had problems with processing Japanese sometimes. I can't remember which one. So the only tool we really have for Japanese is PO mode in Emacs. Or I think some people use G-Edit.
Some use G-Edit, some use PO Edit also.
Yeah.
PO Edit is a GTK tool,
yeah.
if I remember it. It's quite good tool. Recently, it has a problem currently with new features by GetText. I don't have such files handy, but with the recent version of GetText, when you pipe a message into message merge, and the PO files are updated because the strings change, the former string is kept as a comment with. Sharp pipe and form a string. And PO Edit unfortunately doesn't cope very well with this thing because it moves the comments at the top of the blocks, which is not the. I sent an RC bug against PO Edit for that because it completely breaks PO file. But
apart from that, UEdit is a good tool. It's a lighter than Cleverbot. And it is still the advantage of these tools. You see the original file and the translation below together, and there are internal checks, like spell checking, of course, but also variable checking and the like.
Well, actually, you can even use Boodle if you want.
Yeah.
It's just experimental. Sometimes we've broken everything over there. So, not exactly this Boodle, but you can have Boodle.
A Boodle.
Yeah.
There's a FileTap plugin mode for the VI improved editor for PO mode. That's quite useful. It has keyboard shortcuts to jump to an untranslated string to the next fuzzy marked string, and you can even, when you're in the, when you have the complete sources, you can also open the place where this string was defined, so you can look around in the source if you are unfamiliar with how this string might be really used in that place. So you can look at that one too. I just sent a message to the maintainer of that script that he adds support for this new get text previous thing, so it might be possible soon to get the previous and the current original string diff for those.
Yeah, so showing a diff of both would be very interesting.
Yes.
Because
of the message ID?
Excuse me?
A diff of the message ID. If a string is marked fuzzy, it's done because the message ID that's currently there for the string is similar to a previous translated message string. And if you can get a diff between those two strings, it would be immensely useful because you see what really has changed and not only see the new string and have to figure out yourself if there was something changed. And I sent a message to mail this morning to the maintainer of this po.vim file plugin so he can add a new keyboard shortcut to just get the diff of those strings.
Yeah, that would be interesting. Because
Nicholas asked me in one of the I-18N sessions.
That would be useful. Cleverbot has nothing currently. You just see the former translation, but you have to guess what has changed.
Exactly.
Better than before. Before you had just a fuzzy, but you had no idea of what changed. And when this is a usage line of the package, for instance, good luck to find what has changed. So, well, the tools can be still improved.
So we have a lot to do with the tools, and we know there's problems, but we have a web interface, and we have the editor, so, well, we can work.
Yeah, I think when it comes to all these processes, QA is mostly made of processes. All the work we're currently doing on the Putol server is a place to improve all this. That's where it has to go on. And I think this is mostly not thinking deeper about processes, is mostly what is currently missing in the approach of Ubuntu through Rosetta. Because the tool is here, it's very nice, it's neat, it's flashy and good, very, very easy to use for new translator. But as far as I know, there are no processes behind it. So
barely anyone can jump and say, okay, I'm a translator for Georgian and I speak Georgian very well and I pick this file, blah, 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 I translate to Georgian. Commit, okay. This goes to GNOME direct and so on. It does not go to GNOME. So we are currently slow in Debian when it comes at these things. But it's probably better to be slow than to do things too hastily. And things organize themselves. 2 years ago, there were two or three teams with robots. Each team had its own robot. Now we have like 10 and maybe soon Japanese, and it's the chaos organized also. And there will be still always chaos anyway.
And we have more strong feeling of a team.
Yeah, we have more strong feeling of team and cooperation between teams, probably. I don't know if there are some other concerns discussed on IRC.
Well, yeah, another question would be to what other places you think that you want to improve what is working on this? Is there a question on IRC?
That's the question.
We have been discussing that since DevCon 6. Well, Christian probably has been discussing that much more time than others. But since DevCon 6, we have prototyped some things and defined some process, some workflows, some base assumptions that we must have some things, we need to have others, and we really would like to have another one. And Puru is moving some things in the direction that we want. Yesterday we still find some critical things that are not working exactly like we want. I think that one of the things that needs improvement, and we will work on that. That's a consensus during the DevConf 7 documentation. We need to spread some information. So some people doesn't know about the robots, doesn't know about how they work, what they do. They don't seem to remember that we now have an i18n server that should be used. And so I think that things that we need improvement are some documentation and the whole workflow of what we are doing. It's the main things. And of course, Poodle, being our tool, needs a lot of improvement to achieve what we really want them to do. But that really needs coordination with Poodle people, that we learned in the past. That there is not just pop up, write something, and tries to force Poodle people to merge it. It will not work that way. It needs to come from Poodle's side, working inside Poodle and understanding what can be done and how to do that. One of the things that there's a small, very, very small problem that from time to time appears is that while we are building the consensus of being a team, we still have the afraid of being a team sometimes. That's why we look to the i18n wiki and we see that we start like calling
the Knights of Fikiki, because that way nobody will complain. But we really want to have more of this visibility of being working on QA and having people doing coordination on our local teams inside a BDI team, so the Knights of Fikiki.
You don't say me. You say Niki Niki Wiki.
How did you choose the name Niki Niki?
It's I forgot the name. It's the same guys that give name to this fun, the Monty Python sketch. They have one episode that is the Knights of Niki.
Knights of Ni.
Yeah.
The original ones are the Knights of Ni, because they say Ni. We talk too much in the translation stuff, so we say Knights of Niki Niki Wiki. Poor reason.
Yeah.
We make stupid jokes.
Yes.
You should zoom on Grizu. He's very interesting person.
Which is named hard to see.
He knows he has a lot of work to do. Yeah. I think there are still things to... I don't know if you run out of time or whatever.
5:35.
I think you have more like 10 minutes.
10 minutes.
So, if we have anything more, I think it's about good enough. We've talked good enough.
Yeah. Again, I talk too much. You know about the team.
We wrote an announcement, right? For what we have discussed.
Yeah. Maybe. Not quite too soon.
Well, thank you for all your inputs. It's very nice to have the injection team, all of you, and via IRC, the Japanese team.
Yeah, that's so nice. Yeah. Do you have Kenshi on IRC too?
Well, Kenshi is probably not, because it's 1 a.m., he's already asleep. So, without this meeting, I don't think we really saw the value of IoT .net and robots are so useful. So, yeah,
it can give some push, some more publicity about these tools, which we should do more often, actually. I always forget to do. Yeah, thanks for proxying with IC, thanks.
Thank you very much.